Curing HIV, how far have we come? It's a sure sign of cure research progress that today, it can be hard to keep track of the various cases of HIV having been cured or controlled in the absence of antiretroviral therapy, ART. The cases that tend to make headlines are those resulting from high-risk stem cell transplants, which are only an option for a very small number of people with both HIV and certain blood cancers. More numerous are those cases where virus still remains, but is somehow kept in check by the immune system. While we're still some distance from having a cure that's easy to administer, affordable and, above all, widely available, researchers are learning from all of these cases. So today, we're curing some people, some of the time, the first step toward curing most people, most of the time. To help you make sense of it all, we've put together this summary of cure, or treatment-free control, cases to date, and we'll add to it as others come to light. Berlin patient. The first known case of HIV cure was Timothy Ray Brown, who had been living with HIV for over a decade when he developed acute myeloid leukemia. He received chemotherapy, total body irradiation, and two stem cell transplants. Each transplant came from the same donor, who had the CCR5-delta-32 genetic mutation. The case was published in 2009 and was subject to intense scrutiny before scientists agreed he was likely cured. Although he remained free of any signs of HIV infection, Timothy passed away in September 2020 following a relapse of his leukemia. City of Hope patient. At the AIDS 2022 conference in Montreal in July, researchers reported that a yet-to-be-named man living with HIV had been treated for acute myeloid leukemia using stem cells from a donor with the CCR5-delta-32 genetic mutation, which renders cells almost impervious to HIV infection. The man had stopped taking antiretroviral therapy, ART, for 14 months with no sign of rebounding HIV. He is the oldest person to date to receive a stem cell transplant that appears to have resulted in an HIV cure, and had been living with HIV the longest, since 1988. About 6 months after AIDS, 2022, he disclosed his identity, Paul Edmonds, in order to share his personal story. Dusseldorf patient. Researchers confirmed in February 2023 that a 53-year-old man in Germany referred to as the Dusseldorf patient, now known to be Mark Frank, has been cured of HIV. Like the London and Geneva patients, the Dusseldorf patient is a member of AMFAR's iSystem cohort of people living with HIV and cancer who received stem cell transplants. His acute myeloid leukemia was treated with a CCR5-delta-32 stem cell transplant in 2013. A few months after the transplant, he experienced a relapse of his leukemia, which was treated successfully without additional stem cell transplantation. His case was reported at the same conference as the London patient case. Despite discontinuing ART in 2018, again under closely monitored conditions, he continues to show no signs of HIV infection, London patient. More than 10 years after Timothy Brown's cure, in 2019 Adam Castillejo was reported likely cured following a CCR5-delta-32 stem cell transplant to treat his Hodgkin lymphoma. He received a reduced-intensity preparatory chemotherapy, but no irradiation prior to his transplant. He stopped taking ART under close supervision in 2017 and remains HIV-free, New York patient. In February 2022, researchers reported that a woman living with HIV in New York had been treated for her acute myeloid leukemia using CCR5-delta-32 stem cells from cord blood combined with adult stem cells from a relative, the first such haplocord blood transplant leading to a potential HIV cure. At the time of the report, the woman had stopped ART for 14 months with no sign of HIV infection. The case was subsequently reported in the journal Cell on March 16, 2023. Geneva patient. In July 2023, news broke at the International AIDS Society Conference on HIV Science, IAS 2023, that a man in his early 50s may have been cured of HIV, also through a stem cell transplant. Notably, the transplant used wild-type donor cells, which are not near impervious to HIV infection like the donor cells with the CCR5-delta-32 genetic mutation used in the previous cases. After 20 months, the man remains undetectable and it remains to be seen whether he has in fact been cured. At the AIDS 2022 conference, Dr. Javier Martinez Picado discussed the phenomenon of exceptional elite control, people who Without the use of ART, control HIV viral replication and do not experience immune dysfunction. There is no disease progression and they have extraordinarily low burdens of HIV, which can be detected only using specialized laboratory tests. They may experience a loss of anti-HIV antibodies over time and have relatively weak immune responses against HIV, both signs that the body is no longer fighting HIV infection. 6 such individuals have been followed for more than 30 years, and Dr. Martinez Picado proposed that they may be considered a good model for an HIV cure. Esperanza patient, following the case of Lorraine Willenberg, see below. A second such case was announced in 2022 in a woman named after her hometown in Argentina. She was diagnosed with HIV in 2013 and has taken antiretroviral therapy only for brief periods during 2 pregnancies. Nonetheless, researchers including Dr. Su Yu and Matthias Lichterfeld, both AMFAR grantees, as well as collaborators in Argentina, have been unable to find intact or replication-competent virus in her. San Francisco patient, Lorraine Willenberg was diagnosed with HIV in 1992. Unlike almost all people living with HIV, she has never needed to take antiretroviral therapy to control her HIV infection. In 2020, Drs. Yu and Lichterfeld Anno. San Francisco patient, Lorraine Willenberg was diagnosed with HIV in 1992. Unlike almost all people living with HIV, she has never needed to take antiretroviral therapy to control her HIV infection. In 2020, Drs. Yu and Lichterfeld announced that they were unable to find any intact HIV in her body, despite searching in more than 1 billion cells, raising the intriguing possibility that her immune system not only controls the virus but may have, for all intents and purposes, eliminated it.